Hello, in this lab we will be seeing a bunch of chemical reactions, and your job is to write the formula and name of the solid product of these aqueous reactions. Aqueous means dissolved in water, and the solid product is called a precipitate. The dissolved compounds are written above each column and to the left of each row. A drop of each solution will be put in each column and in each row, producing a precipitate in each box. You will write the correct formula and name of each precipitate by combining the ions written below each compound. For example, FeCl3 and AgNO3, write the compound that forms the precipitate from the silver ion and the chloride ion using the rules of balancing charges for the formula and the ion names for the compound name. You will also write a visual description of the precipitate. In this first example, the formula that balances charges is AgCl. The name of the ions and therefore the compound is silver chloride. For the description of the precipitate, you will have to wait to see the actual reaction coming right up. So we're working with solutions here, and the solutions are made from solid compounds dissolved in water. So what do these compounds look like before they're dissolved in water? So this is Na2CO3. This is PbNO32. This is AgNO3. This is MgSO4. This is FeCl3. You can see it's kind of chunky. And this beautiful blue stuff is CuSO4. Also kind of chunky. So all the compounds we're using in this lab are not dry, like this Ki here, but they're dissolved in water. And so we can no longer see the actual compound because it is no longer visible when dissolved in water. And so each liquid drop that you see, you're not actually looking at the compound itself. You're looking at the compound dissolved in water, which is not visible. Okay, so the first one is AgNO3. The next one is PbNO32. The next one is CuSO4. And the next one is FeCl3. Kind of skipped one, but the FeCl3, I'm going to put that aside because we're going to use it again. Here's MgSO4. Now we're going back to the FeCl3. Because now we're going across. Before we were going vertically, now we're going horizontally, and FeCl3 is the first one at the top. Observe what happens. Okay. Let's back up a bit to get a better understanding of what is occurring here. Let's magnify first just the AgNO3 solution to see what is going on in there, and then take an up-close view of what happens when the FeCl3 is added. The most important thing to understand here is that in solution, the AgNO3 compound no longer exists. It has been broken up into individual aqueous silver ions and nitrate ions, which are freely moving in their aqueous environment. The added FeCl3 solution actually adds two more types of ions, aqueous iron ions and aqueous chloride ions. The most interesting part about this is that the compound AgCl, silver chloride, does not dissolve in water. It is insoluble. And so whenever a silver ion collides with a chloride ion, they will bond and form an ionic solid in the water. There are actually many, many quadrillions of ions in these small droplets of solution. And so the AgCl compound quickly builds to the point where we can see it with our eyes. The same mechanism occurs in all the other boxes, with the ions written below the compounds coming together to form this solid compound. The next one is Ki. Okay, the next one is NaOH. The next one is Na2CO3. And then finally, Na3PO4. Okay, and just to get a different perspective, I'm going to slip a white piece of paper underneath, and that gives you a little bit different perspective on the colors. This one, the FeCl3 plus NaOH, was not very visible with the black background.